Okay, I am back with a new video and it's been a while, I know. Apologies, I am here and I will do this video. I've been busy working in the garden and we had a flood in my street, so that caused a lot of issues. I have been enjoying a lot of walks. I've been going on a lot of walks and they were beautiful. The weather was great in September. And I just didn't get around to making a video, but I am planning a 72 demon ritual with a certain purpose. And what I wanted to do is make a potion or a herbal blend or a sea salt bath with certain flowers. And I just couldn't make up my mind. Now, the easy thing is to just go into town and make a list of ingredients that you want to add to your potion, let's say potion or herbal blend, and you buy them and you throw them together and that's that. That's not the way that I like to go about making something like that. I've been using oracles, I've been using tarot, I've been using evocations and invocations, all to prepare for my next step. And the way that I like to go about these things is to just take my dog, go for a very long walk or hike and gather my ingredients. And, you know, when I feel drawn to use certain things, then I just walk through the fields and forests and I feel drawn to use certain things. I am going to contemplate about what I am about to do. I connect with all 72 demons and then I throw together a combination of ingredients. So I was thinking beech and oak with beech nuts and chestnuts and but that just didn't feel right. And I kept walking and I kept walking and I did another walk and I went on a hike. And then I was thinking, you know, sunflowers and corn. The sunflowers are small but beautiful and I was looking for corn. Turned out that the farmers in my area decided to avoid corn this year and do something else, like growing cannabis or certain grains. And I just didn't know what to do. So I was like, I almost gave up. And I was thinking, you know, I will do this ritual maybe next month or in the new year. And then suddenly it, you know, I stumbled onto wild sage. The smell of these are delish. It's absolutely amazing. So I just found these growing somewhere. And I don't know where, how they ended up there, but I was able to, you know, find these. So this was the first hit. This was the first internal yes that I got. I had to use my knife and cut off a little bit. This is more than enough. And this was my first yes. So I moved on. I kept walking and walking and walking. Because that's what witches do, right? They walk a lot. It's like being homeless. You just follow your gut, follow your inner witch, follow your intuition and let the environment, the things in their environment, the beings in the environment speak to you. And it's not about me making a decision. This is what I want. This is what I want to do. This is a great idea. Let's offer some red wine and goat milk and candy. And, you know, I am not about stuff like this. I like to feel drawn to a certain area where I pop up into something like this. Another thing is chicory. I love, absolutely love blue flowers. So I'm going to dry these. And I only picked four because these four spoke to me. The rest wanted to be left alone. And you have to honor that. And then there was this flower. I don't know what this is called in English. It's a cornflower. A korenbloem. So it's not a new one. It's a little bit messed up already because of the weather. but it's still a beautiful blue. So I picked one. And another thing that I bumped into was beads. And you think that beads are beads, but they don't always make it as beads. The leaves are great in salad. So I was stumbling through another field, tripping, falling, crawling. There was mud everywhere. There were rain puddles everywhere. And this is what I stumbled onto. These are beets that simply didn't make it. You know, you have to, beets grow seeds and these seeds have to be separated. And then you put them in the ground and you start to pick leaves. And then they will grow a beautiful red beet. If that doesn't happen and they just start to take over the environment, or, you know, they decide to, they don't really take over the environment. You know, if you're walking in a field, they just pop up here and there. So here you can see little beets. So these leaves are great in salads. So I have something that I can eat, flowers that I can eat, a herb that I can eat, and I've got these leaves that I can eat. So I am going to use these miniature dollhouse beets, and I am thinking about making a salad blend, or I'm going to put them in one of these wearable urns that I really, really like. I've got loads of these. I replaced the chain with paracord because it's much stronger. It's not as elegant as this, but it's much, much stronger. So there will be paracord on this. So maybe I will do both. And I'm not, I was so tempted to, you know, when I got this, I became completely enthusiastic and energized. And when I bumped into the flowers, I felt great. And then the last ingredient just, you know, made my day. This made my day. These are great in salads. You can eat them. Maybe I will go back and pick some more, but I want to make sure that they will show up next year, so I can't overdo it. I was so tempted in going after mushrooms that could add, or, you know, other herbs or flowers, or, you know, make a complete bouquet of all kinds of stuff, but I was connecting with the demons, and this is what they wanted. This is what they felt comfortable with. This is what they would accept. And then you can go overboard with finding more, picking more, adding more, but you have to know when to stop. So I will dry these and put them in salt, I think. I'm not 100% sure yet, but I think this is going to be a salt blend, and I'm going to add some in this. And now, finally, after a couple of weeks, I feel confident that the request that I have in mind will be honored. So this is great. These little beads just made my day. It's just when something like this happens, then you know you are on the right track, and that they are already listening. That the demons are already listening to, responding to your desire. So, not a great video, but for me, this is bliss. Bye.